All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, mamas and papas, nobody's whining anybody. This is the show that you thought you were tuning in for. This is Budweiser's Kings of Football show, the show that takes you straight through the Premier League. That is, of course, the English Premier League. And it is literally one of the most intriguing runnings ever. Yes, there's a lot of action in the Premier League this weekend, and we're looking excited to find out what will be the fate of the Premier League title. What team will be getting closer to being relegated? Well, we'll be finding out all of that and the thoughts of the experts as we get into it right here on Budweiser's Kings of Football show. I am Fola Jimmie Luashegun, James Akinshola, or you can simply call me King Jimmy. If you don't know, I'm an Arsenal fan, and today I am not alone. But let me first introduce my those that don't like what is happening at the Emirates Stadium. Ladies and gentlemen, he's here and he will always be here to take the shots and also receive the shots. He is my friend, my brother, one of Nigeria's most traveled journalists, the one and only Pooja in the house. How you doing, my brother?
Good. Thanks for the accolade, but but away from the accolade, we go again this week.
We go again where?
It's per week billing. You need to continue to go again because
they accept you midweek billing too. You know,
back to back. So let's see what happened this week. But of course, you know, Arsenal good run, but we won't leave their back. We continue to climb their back.
We actually think we need you on our backs to keep pushing us forward, because without you guys, I don't think there's we'll be resting on our laurels, and right now there's nothing to rest on. We need everything we could get. One man that is not resting and is always galvanizing support and making sure everybody knows of what's going on at the Emirates Stadium, his darling Emirates Stadium, the team that he supports, he's been supporting for years on end. He is, of course, here in studio today, not on our X space as usual, because he never misses the show. He always wants to get someone that is talking nonsense. And today, he's here to talk to them about the nonsense they've been talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, my friend, my brother, Sir Leo da Silva, my brother.
Jimmy.
Maji.
How do you feel?
It's almost time.
We're so close. Random people have been stopping me, messaging me.
This elephant has not fallen down.
Are we going to do it?
Hey.
And you know, I'm trying to encourage Arsenal fans, because obviously back-to-back title challenges is not easy.
It's not easy. We need to first take your accolades for that one.
Yes, you need to first be, you know, and first time in the Champions League in like 7 years.
A lot of firsts.
It's a lot to take in.
Right.
And haters, even the ones next to me, are not happy. They're not happy. They always try to diminish the achievements.
They do it effortlessly.
Every single time. Any small thing like this.
Look at
Arsenal.
They're snapping picture in the field.
Arsenal. Exactly.
Over celebrating.
Arsenal.
Like, what is your problem?
The celebration police. First of all, they were the ones policing us.
Now policing them.
They are telling us that we should wait till the last day.
Wow.
Who has waited till the last day? But I know something will happen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Leo da Silva is in the house. Good to have you on the show. As you know, we'll be talking about the title race. There are so many games that are being played this weekend that might be pivotal. Will definitely be pivotal to deciding how the table will shape out moving into the penultimate weekends. I must remind you all as well, regardless of how the Premier League is going, what is a constant is the fact that Budweiser will constantly reward you. And that means that you can get an opportunity to be a part of the winning team if you'd like to win ₦1 million, ₹500,000, or even ₹250,000. Well, if you've not been doing that, it might be tight for you to get that money, because the leaderboard has been on from the beginning of the season, and now we're just about 3 weeks to the end of the dance. Now, we will be telling you who will be winning the $1 million, the $500, and the $250 at the end of the season. So keep your ears peeled for that one, because you might be finding out that shortly. But if you do want to be winning on a weekly basis, you want to test your prediction strengths, then go to our website, which is www.budweiserfootballpredictor.com, and then make your predictions for this week's games. Remember, you can win ₦5,000 airtime just by predicting correct matches this week if you end up in the top five of our leaderboard. There are other platforms that you can use to win right here on the Budweiser Kings of Football show, but I'll be telling you all about them as the show progresses. our super sub question will be coming up real soon. So keep your ears peeled, and we'll be going to our X space at intervals to get your opinions and your thoughts on the topics we're talking about today. Now, of course, I already made mention of it. I can't overflog the issue. The fact still remains, all the talk, all the noise about not London being white or blue, or which other color is there in London?
There's only one color, only red.
Red and blue mixed only together. Red. I don't know. All these things, we've banished all those thoughts. All those people collected at least 3 goals each, everyone in London, at least.
True.
So, Pooja, when I speak on the Arsenal, let your Tottenham side rest. You're not even challenging for Champions League anymore. It's to stay in Europe.
Imagine.
It's such a shame. You don't need to respond to that. Let's just go straight into the show, shall we? It's time for us to take our super sub question of the day. Y'all ready? Everybody, if you're listening right now, our super sub question. Now, before you answer this question, let me tell you about the terms and conditions. All entries must have the hashtag Budweiser Kings of Football Show, and of course the hashtag the KOF super sub. These two elements are very important to how we select our winner. Remember, our winners will be chosen at random. It's going to be one winner for 50,000 naira. 50,000 naira cash prize is available for you if you can get this question correctly. The question for the day is, Barcelona legend Albert Ferrer played in the Premier League for which team? A, Arsenal, B, Liverpool, or C, Chelsea? Please send in your entries for you to stand a chance of winning 50,000 naira, the cash prize that is available for one winner. Remember, all the terms and conditions will apply. Use the hashtag Budweiser Kings of Football Show, hashtag the Kings, the KOF Super Sub. Spurs have proven to be not the team we thought would be important in the title running as initially hoped.
This end of the season, Spurs, anytime there is a sort of pressure on Spurs, Conte said it, the players don't like to play under pressure. So when there is
But these are different players now, though.
It's the culture. He said that's the history of the Tottenham. Wow. You know, I'm quoting him, the history of the Tottenham.
We have a Tottenham fan right beside you.
Yes, and you see, I don't like the fact that football knowledge has gone to stats. You understand? I don't believe in it. Because I started watching football during a period where we didn't have phones.
Where we weren't keeping stats.
Where we were not keeping stats. People just literally use their eye to see who has the greatest effect on this in this competition or on this football team. And they give the person the award. So someone like Zidane in this generation would have not won Ballon d'Or.
Of course.
So I don't really like when people say stats. Your stats should take you somewhere. It should take you somewhere tangible.
I see the shots you're taking out. You get what I'm saying? There, but it's okay.
Not even Haaland. I'm even talking like Kane, for example. You scored the highest amount of goals back to back. That means you were missing in key games. That's why Spurs did not win the league.
Do you think Liverpool have already given up on the title, or do you think they still think they're in with a shout, considering Arsenal could slip up, City could slip up?
Well, I think they're not. I think in their psychology, I think they've given up. I think the form of, you know, Arsenal and you know, Man City is too on a stretch than what Liverpool are dishing out. You know, back to back, they've not been convincing. You know, Salah, you know, Klopp again, you know, the indoor, you know, internal issues, you know, at the press conference was saying, does he have anything to say about Salah, you know, transfers, or even he's going to say it's the next season. So there are lots of baggage is going on at the team. But if you look at Spurs, I think Leo has actually, you know, dissected most things about Spurs. I think for Spurs, even for the manager, you know, you come into a team that doesn't have a mentality, and you're saying you're not going to play in a certain way. To actually, you know, you don't start a team before you play a team. It's not done in the Premier League. And you've done it. And now, you know, after losing against Chelsea, he's now coming back to say there will be changes in his team. For a team who has considered 11 added goals behind Nottingham Forest. That is, they are the second team to concede more added goals in the EPL. And you're saying you don't want to play one. Some type of way you want to play in your way you want to, no, it's not done in the Premier League.
Now we can allow Manchester United fans to enter the space because the relevant ones now come into play. We're talking about Manchester United taking on Crystal Palace. As harsh as my comments just now might sound to most, that is the reality. Manchester United are playing for nothing when it comes to the Premier League. Even their push for European positions, they can't be caught, they can't catch anyone, so they're hanging in the balance. Crystal Palace, on the other hand, they've had a rich vein of form recently, taking out Liverpool, as they usually do, from the title race. They've also managed to secure pivotal wins, and this has all been down to Olise and Eze getting to play together.
My Igbo brothers.
You understand?
Yes. So.
You understand? So now, having said that, they go against the Manchester United side that has an on-fire Bruno Fernandes. He's definitely in the running to be announced as the player of the month for last month because he scored 6 goals. I don't think anyone else scored. Well, Cole Palmer scored more, but total contribution and games played as well. I do believe that Bruno Fernandes is in pole position for that. But considering all said and done, Manchester United versus Crystal Palace, what say you, Leo?
So I always tell people that don't ever underestimate new manager bounce.
It's a Monday night football game as well, like at Selhurst Park.
New manager bounce is probably one of the craziest phenomenon in football because you don't really know. A team can be playing absolute trash one weekend. They get a new manager that week.
All of a sudden.
And the next week, you start playing like Prime Milan. You understand? But this time around, you know, I give kudos to the new manager.
Right.
I think he has a certain way of playing. And with the crop of players Crystal Palace have, they have talented players. You see, it feels like they have a lot of raw players you get that can be world beaters. Like we see people are trying to buy Olise. You know, they've been looking at his...
a la Chelsea.
You get people, are, you know, they've been looking at his release clause and all those kind of things. He's been on the news for a while. So they have those kind of players. They've always had those type of players. So with the new manager and playing against United, United would always concede. Crystal Palace have been creating a lot of chances a lot more. Yeah. They've been holding on to possession.
Yeah.
That's something United find hard to do. That's why they concede a lot of shots. They don't know how to play anything apart from counter-attack very effectively.
Facts.
So anytime it's not effective, it looks like they are in hell. Any team can just, you know, have a good day against them, basically. So with the way Crystal Palace is set up now, playing possession football, trying to walk the ball into the net with Mateta, and Mateta has been quite clinical, you know. People don't talk about him whole lot.
He has been.
But he has been quite clinical this season. So I think it's going to be a very tough game for United at Selhurst Park as well. And I feel like it's going to be a win for Crystal Palace.
A win for Crystal Palace? That's your call?
Selhurst That's my Park? Call.
Monday night football?
Monday night football. So I'm looking at maybe 2-1.
2-1. All right. What's your take?
I think, you know, too, to what you said, because, you know, Man United, like I said too, they're in patches, you know, a lot of, you know, issues going on with them, you know, for a team that has a game to play, you know, this weekend, and all of a sudden you're talking about Sancho, you're talking about how you're going to bring him back. You know, your target for the season is not even well spelled out. You don't even know what you're doing. They concede a lot of goals. I think they're up there, you know, with teams that are considered a lot of shots behind Sheffield United. And what do you, and if you look at their goal difference as well, it looks like they don't know what they're doing. You can say Bruno is coming to the fold, but if your midfielder is the one getting the goals, there's no way forward for that team. That's why they are stuck in that position, and Chelsea can cut them off. So it's a very big deal for them to go to, you know, Crystal Palace and get maybe a point or a win, because if failure to do that, if Chelsea win their game, you know, they tally with point with Chelsea, with Man United. So for Man United, they need to put their hands in order. You know, Garnacho all of a sudden is not scoring goals again. Rashford
is being considered on his way out.
He's done and dusted. Yeah. You know, if for a press conference to be held and they are asking, you know, Ten Hag, are you going to let all the teams, all the players to go? It shows that there's nobody that is on that level again when it comes to playing for Manchester United. So, and of course, next season they are going to lose a lot of players as well. You know, a lot of players are not informed. Casemiro, Varane, Amrabat. There are so many baggages.
Unhappy
in that
players.
So, for Crystal Palace, manager bounce, they are playing well. You know, they are playing good football and at home.
They're excited.
Yeah. I think the best Man United can get is a draw.
All right, the best Man United can get is a draw, but what will they get?
1-1.
It's a draw. Still. All right, I said earlier on that I'd like to have the Manchester United fans enter the space right now, but I don't know what you guys are doing. Is there a Manchester United fan in here? Please let us know.
What if they won't come talk now?
Femi, you seem to be the one that is raising your hand, but hold on a second. Let's talk to thank you, God always. Thank you, God always. That is Gwine 4. Talk to me, my brother. What team do you support?
Good morning, everybody. I support Manchester United. And I've been hearing how you guys have been dragging us.
You support Manchester United?
Yes, and you guys have been dragging us for like the past 10 minutes, you know.
We've been unfair to Manchester United for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, I mean,
can you be fair to them?
Well, for the most majority of this season, we've been playing without a stable back line, you know.
And whose fault is that?
That's just luck. I guess we're just unfortunate. It's nobody's fault, actually. Mm.
So based that it's just unfortunate, let's hope for something fortunate for you in this match against Crystal Palace. So what's your take about the match specifically?
Oh man, there's nothing for us. So man, no lie.
My guy said there's nothing for us, but yeah, you're saying we are taking shots at you.
I'm trying to be optimistic, but you know, I mean, I don't see anything.
So what's your prediction?
I'm hoping for a draw, you know, but I expect us to get back.
All right, let's save you your let's save you your blushes. Thank you so much. Bye.
Yeah.
I already mentioned the fact that I need everybody to get on board to our Predict and Win website, which is, of course, www.budweiserfootballpredictor.com. And it's very simple. If you are able to make your predictions, you can win airtime on a weekly basis. Or if you've been part of it from the start of the season, you stand a very huge chance of winning 1 million naira, 500,000, or even 250,000 naira as the top three on the leaderboard. Before I go into our Joker segment, where we ask a question that is not necessarily connected to this week's games in the Premier League, I just wanted to touch on the relegation battle as it stands. One team that is Sheffield United, but I'll go with you, Pooja, first. What do you think?
Well, I just love the relegation battle this season because this time around you're not fighting against teams that are not relegating. So the relegation rivals are going to take point from themselves.
Yeah.
So because Nottingham Forest are still going to play Burnley, so they're fighting themselves. So I love how it's shaping up this season. Complain has always want to play expressive football. You can't play, that's what is happening to Luton as well. You know, you play good football. You don't have the skill set to defend, and you continue to play that expressive football, conceding a lot of goals. They've scored a lot of goals, Luton, and they've conceded a lot of goals. There's no game except, I think, Man City. They've scored in all games this season. And if you look at Burnley as well, you can't play expressive football. You don't have the skill set to play that kind of football. You know, just deploy the Sean Dyche's kind of way or the Sam Allardyce kind of way. It's the business end of the season. What you need is not good football. It's good points.
Okay, so obviously Sheffield United have been confirmed relegated.
Yeah, they have nothing to play for.
They have nothing to play
pride,
for.
But they're even already, when they play for pride, they still collected five. So
of course. But with Nottingham Forest this season, it just looks like
they flattered to deceive.
When they came into the league, they didn't have a definite structure of what they wanted
they just
to
spent
do.
Money.
They just kept on buying and buying and buying. And one thing we know about buying and buying and buying is you cannot really strike the real balance of your team. I feel like that's what has affected them.
Two straight seasons of buying recklessly.
You know, like last week now, I feel Awoni should have been the striker instead of Chris Wood, But that's the problem. If you had just Awoni instead of Awoni and Chris Wood, there would not be a question. And you would just back him and you would try to feed him and play to his strengths. But this one, you had a Chris Wood that could not even score from 2 yards out,
But so he has one of the best efficiency rates as a striker.
He has one of the best efficiency rates, but he's not, I don't think he is better than Awoni.
Someone said Awoni he's a Man City fan, that's why he missed us.
Well, maybe, but Awoni has played against the big boys and he has always turned up. He has always been the gunman.
There's a lot to question about why he's not starting those games.
Exactly. So that's the problem. They have I don't know if they are trying to play into like the British media that the British boy must start and whatnot and all those kind. You know, England is very, very funny sometimes like that.
Of course. All right, so that's our relegation outlook. Now, let's quickly go to our Joker question of the day. Now, this Joker question, as we usually do, we like to just throw out a question that is not necessarily concerning what's happening in present time and day, but the question is just for public conversation as well. How many goals would you score if you played for Manchester City? Which players would make your top five? Those are the kind of questions we're going to be asking. We've asked that before, and we're going to be asking those kind of questions. But today's question is very simple and straightforward. Would you rather start a player on your favorite team but come second in the Premier League every year, or be a bench player on your rival's team and win five straight titles? So, for example, would you rather remain a Saka at Arsenal, or be a who's a bench warmer at Man City?
Maybe a Kevin Phillips.
Yeah, well, before he left,
he won the treble without doing anything.
Backup goalkeeper, whatever his name is.
Yeah,
the backup goalkeeper at Man City. Which would you rather be? Saka that hasn't got any title in 5 years. Or how many years?
So I'd rather be a Saka, because you can show your talent, and even if you don't win a title like Harry Kane, you can always move to a bigger team.
You can always command a big box.
Yes, and you can, because you cannot command a higher salary if you are not playing. And I'll look at my Nigerian family that I need to take care of. There is no way I want to be on the bench. How can
brought it home there.
Yes. How can I tell the club that, see, you have to pay me on the same level with Vinicius Junior. We are given the same outputs in Europe and all of that stuff.
But you're winning titles. We are winning titles. So, I mean, you're gaining the experience of understanding what it is to win.
There's nothing. Look, Kevin Phillips won the treble.
Yeah.
He went to West Ham. He still benched at West Ham.
Yep.
So there's no way you can show your quality. Because at the end of the day, if you spend like 5-6 years, maybe you come from a very high level when they bought you, and at the club you started sitting on the bench for like 2-3 games. The next 4 maybe window, you will not be a thing to reckon with. Saka continued to play. Look at Cole Palmer.
Yeah.
He was on the bench, you know. I said, I want to play. Mm-hmm. Let me move. And now he has moved.
He has moved. And he's showing his...
There's no way they want to buy Cole Palmer for £65 million anymore.
Exactly.
Facts. And that's a fair point. That's a very fair point. So I'll leave it on that, because that is quite... that is exactly what it is. Cole Palmer could have stayed at Manchester City and be going for titles.
Yeah.
Being his
bench warmer.
A rarely used player. Because there's nobody he's going to start ahead of at Manchester City. But look at him at Chelsea today. He's... Next contract is going to be the big one.
With that form alone, he's going to Euros with England.
He's going to play for England. Yes. He's already in the running for PFA England. Player. You don't get to be in those positions by sitting on the bench. Yes. I think you guys hit the nail on the head. Well, you don't get to be a part of the Kings of Football show if you're either in Enugu, Delta, Abia, Cross River, Port Harcourt, Akwa Ibom, or Imo State. If you don't tune in on Thursday at 10 p.m. to watch every part of the Kings of Football show, it's specifically made available to you in those regions because we want you to be a part of what we enjoy doing every Saturday right here. Remember, if you're listening on X Space, we do encourage you to join us every 11 a.m. but you can come as early as 10:45. You know, just hang around the X Space so that, you know, by the time we start, you start with us. And of course, if you're watching us on YouTube, we usually get every episode that we run on Saturdays. It becomes available to you on Mondays right here on YouTube. We do have opportunities for you guys to win as well. Check in the comments and you will see the questions that will be asked right there. And as far as Budweiser is concerned, we will always be giving you an opportunity to take the world that you exist in. Leo, any last words as we come to a close?
I want Arsenal fans to be extremely grateful, first of all. We've had back-to-back league title challenges, and we've also been back in the Champions League. So no matter what we achieve this season, it has been an amazing season for these young crop of players. You know, they've really done well. And I feel like, because you see, the reason why I'm talking to Arsenal fans is because we're the most reactionary fan base ever. and it's, you know, everyone is trying to trigger us.
It's the hope
you
that
know
kills
every
us.
Single football writer. That's why I don't read the Football Writers Award, because every single football writer right from the start did not even put us in top four. And to now even bust your head, in January they did a redo. The highest they put us was third.
Wow.
And it was about two people that put us in third. So now, when you get to the end of the season, when football writers will start saying, you lost the league, those people never predicted us to win the league in the first place.
So why would they be... Exactly.
They never predicted us to win the league in the first place. So don't get triggered by any single thing that happens. These boys have done really, really well. You know, we had an amazing outing in the Champions League, I can't lie. You know, Bayern definitely had more experience than us. But yep. Next season, we're going to be back in the shout. Arteta will be backed, and it will be a very, very good game. So please don't listen to stats. Watch football by yourself. Don't say because they gave man of the match to Odegaard, Odegaard was the best player for you. With your eyes, you can decide who the best player for you was. You don't need to go on Twitter to argue with anybody. Just say, let's put your opinion. Even if they are busy, that, oh, you went trophyless, it does not matter.
Ah, Leo. Leo, you sabisha. I said final word, but back to your final essay. I love it.
That's the compression passage.
Final word, Pooja.
We are on the other side. We trigger fans.
This guy, relentless. He was talking about Invincibles and comparing to Bayern Leverkusen. I'm like, what is wrong with this man, for goodness sake?
We are here to trigger you. So if you don't want to be triggered, we will trigger you. But of course, it's good to be on the show, you know, back to back doing it. The product has given us a lot of memories, you know, Arsenal winning a lot of games as well, high margins as well. And I think this weekend again, we are going to, I think something will happen this weekend. I have a feeling something will happen this weekend.
Might not be what everybody is expecting.
Yeah. Because I don't want the season, because it will not be interesting anymore. Yes. Every weekend, week in, week out, both teams are winning games. At the end of the day, Man City will just run away with the title. Yeah. I think there will still be a twist, so that the last game of the season, there could be like a
go
final.
Go down to the wire.
Go down the wire, so.
All right, well said. I must say personally, thank you guys for joining me on the show.
Oh, Jimmy, always a pleasure.
For each and every one of you watching, wherever you're watching from, remember one thing, no matter what it is, treat others as you would love to be treated. Remember, the world is yours to take, so go out there and grab it. Enjoy your Budweiser as you watch the Premier League live.